Miss Rebecca Dubrovich.
Hi.
Hi.
Sweetheart, you're always reading. What is it now?
Oh, anatomy.
How's our little patient doing?
Better. I checked his wing last night.
It's feeling fine.
Here, a book.
Hey.
Hi.
Don't get so close, it could peck you.
Oh, no, he could, but he wouldn't. What a clever boy. See? Animals only hurt you by accident.
Like people?
No time for philosophy, Dad. I have a class at 2 and I'm on from 4 to midnight.
It's too much working, Becca. A young girl should be out having fun.
Work is fun, Mama. I gotta go.
You don't have time to talk to us anymore.
Right, Daddy.
Over here. Nurse!
What have we got?
Abdominal penetrating wound.
High pressure.
Guy fell from a cross beam about 30 minutes ago.
Typing cross for 4 units. 1, 2, 3.
Nice work.
Yeah, you too. You want to get some coffee?
I can't. I've got to study.
You never stop.
Yeah, well, I don't want to be 50 when I become a doctor, you know? You're already there.
What about this weekend?
I took double shifts.
You're nuts.
Well, I'm taking a week off for the triathlon in Santa Barbara, you know? I've got to make up the time and the money.
Come on, what is it really? Is it me? You don't like me?
Of course not. It's just that there's only so much time in a day.
We find time for the things that interest us.
You made my point.
Welcome to Santa Barbara. Registration for the Motion Zone Triathlon at table number 1.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
This area is only for runners. Are you crazy?
Well, sometimes, but I am also truly sorry.
What a jerk.
Freeway here, isn't it? Huh? I don't know.
Hey,
what do you think?
You guys know where. Hi. I got your note.
Well, gee, what note is that?
Well, the drawing was good. Are you an artist?
I was an art major in college. I'm in the health and fitness business now. Dick Strang.
Rebecca Dubrovich.
Come on, Dick. We gotta go.
Hey. Nice to see you again, Rebecca Dubrovich.
You too.
Let's move.
Notice. Left.
Yeah, Daddy, everything's great. Mom. Mom, I am not burying myself. Mom, I am meeting people. I used to work out at one of those grunt and sweat gyms. I hated it. Nobody cared about the total body.
Ah, that's what we do at the Motion Zone.
Well, they're one of the sponsors here. Thank you.
Thanks.
Do you work for them?
Yeah, sort of.
Are you going to take all those?
Yeah, I take these. I don't need to eat again. One meal a day.
So you're not going to eat that?
No, I'll pick at it, but I'll tell you the truth. The only reason I ordered this was so you wouldn't think I was a nut.
Too late.
That was the hardest part of my divorce. I missed being close to my kids. I still miss the home life.
How many kids do you have?
Two. My son has grown. My daughter, Linda, she still lives at home. She's 16. So was it your dad who got you into sports?
No, not really. I mean, I was always skiing, swimming, jogging.
How much did you run?
About 10 miles a day.
Me too. So what does this tell us?
That we both talk too much. The waiters want to go home.
Yes! All right, great. I'll be home. By the end of the week, we'll close. All right, take care. Bye. Hey, Lewis, I'd like to meet a friend of mine, Rebecca Dubrovich, Lewis Barrows.
Hi.
It's a pleasure to meet you, ma'am. Hey, I understand you just closed that deal.
Yeah, they blinked first.
Now, I tell you, this man here, he really knows how to market his health clubs.
Enjoy yourself.
Motion Zone is yours?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm embarrassed. I didn't realize I was competing for you.
You're not. You are competing to win.
I guess that explains how everybody here seems to know you.
It's just the Texans. That's because we always travel in packs, man.
I have never met a woman who could compete with me in the gym.
I'm not competing. I'm working out.
Baloney. You're as competitive as I am. I gotta tell you, I have never seen such focus and total control. You're incredible.
You know, the rape might never have happened if he had it fixed on me at the parade, but I don't know. After that, I just couldn't stand having people look at me.
Did they ever catch the rapist?
No. Which was the hardest part, you know? It made me so angry. Well, that was 4 years ago. And I did a lot of dumb things. I got very self-destructive.
In what way?
Hung out with a different kind of kids. Got caught up with drugs. I don't know. All that's behind me now. And I don't know why I'm babbling like this. I never really talk about it.
I'm getting depressed.
Why?
You're leaving tomorrow?
Yeah, I know. I'm trying not to think about it. But all good things must come to an end.
Oh, no. Was that one of your dad's slogans? Or?
No, it's Sister Angela's. Whenever we were having fun, she would say, "Girls, line up. All good things must come to an end."
Yeah. I'm glad this was a good thing.
It was a great trip. A lot of it had to do with you.
Well, that makes me feel good. You know, I'm going to be coming back here in March. Why don't you join me?
A few reasons. The hospital, school, money.
Think about it.
Well, he's handsome and successful. He owns that Chana Health Club's Motion Zone, and he works out a lot, so he has a great body.
So we know how he looks. Anything else?
Everything else. It's the best time. Everybody else in the world is asleep.
Except us.
Your wings are better, huh? Yeah, you're gonna be fine, okay? Yes, you will. You ready? Always wanted to be a doctor.
No, doctor. My folks would have killed for me to become a doctor.
What stopped you?
Chemistry, physics, anatomy.
doctor. Most little girls want to grow up to be movie stars.
No. In my fantasies, I marry Albert Schweitzer and we work side by side developing life-saving techniques to change the world. Yeah. I have been in love with Albert Schweitzer since I was 11 and my dad bought me his biography.
Asleep. I carried you over here. I'll go sleep on the couch.
You don't have to do that.
You sure? Take off that robe.
Are you kidding? I don't even let my mother see me naked.
You have the most beautiful body God ever made. Never, ever be ashamed of anything about yourself. You want me or are you hiding from me?
Both.
I can't think of being without you. I'm not feeling these things alone, am I?
No.
Would you ever consider moving to Houston?
I can't. I mean, I have to finish UCLA, then med school. That would be years.
I know. But look, isn't it crazy for us to just put our lives on hold? Everything you do in California, you can do in Houston. and I'll be there to help you.
How can I?
How can we not? I want to be with you. I want to do everything with you. Marriage. Children. And then while we're having this wonderful life, you go to med school. And I could say, this is my wife, Dr. Strang.
How could I explain just I've been moving to Texas to my parents?
Huh. You don't have to.
She has too much to do with her life.
I know. I know. And I want you to know that everything you want for Becca, I also want. Tenfold.
You're too old for her.
Mrs. Dubrovich, if I had known that I was going to meet Rebecca, I would have waited another 15 years to be born.
Dad, I love him so much. He makes me feel safe.
Safe? Is that what this is about, Becca?
Look, Daddy, I know. It's just... Look, after what happened to me, I don't know, it seemed like no matter how much I dreamed of being with someone, there was always this feeling that there was something wrong with me.
No.
Dad, with him, there's nothing wrong.
Well, thank you for your hospitality. You've raised Rebecca to be a very special person. Please share her with me. Just think about it. We won't do anything without your blessing.
Can't stand it another minute.
Me either. This semester's almost over. Then I'm yours.
Yeah.
Tighter. This whole area is cardio fitness hell. Now, sports medicine, nutrition, rehab's all down in the West Wing. I'll show you that.
I'm really impressed. I've never seen a club so equipped.
Well, I care what people want. I want to give it to them. That includes you. Now, how would you like to be the new image for all of our clubs?
No.
All right, Robin, you know what to do, all right? I wanted to just shimmer off the page like gold, like the Golden Girl, all right?
Good to see you.
Here she is, Rebecca. This is my sister, Liz. Her husband, Brian. Watch out for him. He's a lawyer.
Good to meet you.
You know Tom Donato?
Hey, Brian. How are you?
How long have you been a model?
Oh, for about 5 minutes. I'm not a model. I'm pre-med, and I'm actually a registered nurse.
Impressive.
Guess that shuts me up.
I don't want to shut you up. I want the dirt. What was Dick like as a kid?
He was a monster. He terrorized me. Do you know that he once put my finger on a light bulb because he wanted to find out what burning flesh smells like?
Come on, my sister's crazy. I never touched her. Bella! Bella, Bella. How do you like the column, huh?
Well, it is large.
Yes. Well, look, here she is, right here, the Golden Girl herself, Rebecca Dubrovich. This is Bella. She is the columnist for the Houston Star.
Rebecca. First thing to know about Houston is that everybody toots their own horn, but Dick Strang toots his the loudest.
Hey, where were you? We were supposed to work out.
Well, I was getting my life in order.
Hey, that's my job. I missed you. You were gone all day.
Well, I registered for school, and I got the job at Harrington Hospital. Oh, sorry, I've got like 2 minutes. Listen, Mr. Haber, he's spiking, so keep an eye out on him. Doris is half asleep, so you don't really have to worry about her tonight.
Where are you rushing this time?
Cocktails and dinner with Dick. Will you sit with me?
Sure.
Oh, my God, it's a business thing. I cannot be late again or he'll kill me. Thanks. All right, oh, my God. I'll see you later. Okay, bye.
We're not making mammoth noise, are we?
Shh.
Mind your own business. Don't answer it. No, don't open the door for anyone.
Please help me. Somebody,
listen to
please.
Me. Rebecca.
Ma'am, coming. My husband is here. Dick Strang, and I want to see him now. Now! So is that where you go when you say you're away on business?
Could you stop? Could you please stop?
You lied to me. All right, you told me that you were divorced. Do you think that I would have come here to be your mistress?
No, I didn't. That's exactly why I lied. I had to. I didn't see any other way out of this. I knew you wouldn't come here if you knew that I was still married.
Yeah, you were damn right.
Would you just please, would you listen to me? Would you listen to me?
Stop it!
Yes, I lied, but not about the important things. Tina and I have had an open marriage for the last 6 years. I never, ever tried to hide you from anybody. Now, did I? The only reason that Dina and I are still together is for tax purposes. There's a lot of money involved here. There's no feelings, there's no sex, there's just money.
Please, Dick, she's got feelings. A woman showed up here hysterical in the middle of the night looking for her husband.
Well, Dina shows up everywhere being hysterical. This is about us, Rebecca. I know if I told you the truth, I'd lose you.
Yeah, it's all about you, isn't it, Dick? You know, what about me? How dare you put me through this? Do you think I could live in this apartment like some hooker?
Don't leave me. If you do, I won't be able to...
Stop it!
Please believe me.
Oh, I believed you, Dick. I believed everything you ever said to me. You told me that you were divorced, and I believed you. I am done believing you. I'm going home. You go back to your wife.
Hey, Dina, you don't want to do this. I mean, you don't know what it's like out there for a single woman your age.
Save it, Dick.
So you want a divorce, huh? Well, I'll tell you how it's gonna be. The house gets sold, and you get a lump sum, $100,000.
I said save it, Dick. I've already filed for divorce. You wanna talk to me, call my lawyer.
This'll cost you, Dick.
This isn't gonna cost me anything. I don't lose, and you ought to know that. Deal with that, Abby. Please, 2 minutes.
done.
You didn't do it, she did.
My marriage is over, Rebecca. Look, I'm not gonna pretend that I wanted this divorce. I didn't. I mean, I thought that I could have everything. You know, keep my state intact, my family happy, and be with the woman I loved. Thought I could win it all, but I lost you.
Keep? Lost? Win? Dick, those are possession words. I don't really associate them with loving someone.
I know. I didn't trust what we had together enough to tell you the truth. Please, give me another chance. Becca, haven't you ever made a mistake and prayed that you could take it back again? Please. Baby. Let me take it back.
Wow. Wow.
I bought this place for us, but the deed is in your name. And all the furniture we buy will be yours.
Because I want you to feel secure with me. And it's all spelled out right here.
I don't need papers. I just need you.
You've always had me. And you always will.
Gorgeous woman with this incredible body. I think I have to have her right now.
Ah, you've met our next governor. This is Gilbert Wesson and his wife Elaine, Rebecca Dubrovich. Gil, I got somebody I want you to meet. This is Jake Gould. He's loaded. He gave a lot of money to your campaign. Get some more, okay? Riggs Gerard. This is the man who knows everything about everybody. This is
Rebecca. Nice to meet you.
He already knows you.
Hi.
Riggs is the best private investigator in Texas.
You watch the ball.
Excuse me. Good to see you.
What in the hell are you doing here?
Son of a bitch. You have the nerve to buy that tramp a condominium with half of my money?
Oh, what have you been going through my papers?
Half of that townhouse belongs to me.
This is not the time and not the place.
She's living there, isn't she?
Oh, you're drunk.
What do you see in her? Fine. I want you to know that I have hired a new lawyer, Rhoda Burns. She's a real killer. She tells me that when we're through with you, I will own you and the business.
You miserable bitch! You get out of here! You stay out!
No, stop. Look, we don't need half of what we have. Just give it to her.
Over my dead body.
It's making me so nervous. I mean, it's like he's obsessed since Dina filed. He can't talk about anything else.
That's Dick.
Yeah, but I don't get it. I mean, why is this divorce so important to him? He has plenty of money.
Money is only part of it. I mean, Dick can't stand to lose anything. It's a control issue.
Brother's a funny guy. He can be the most charming man in the world until you cross him. Dana crossed him.
Wait a minute. Wait, no, you know what? This is crap. I hired you to get everything you could get on her, didn't I? Yeah, well, don't tell me that, okay? Because everybody is into something, right? What, do I have to do everything myself? Moron. Oh, you see the crap that Dina and her attorney filed in court today? I got a mind. I should call the governor and have that Rhoda Burns disbarred.
Dick, you can't have somebody disbarred.
Let me tell you something. I own this town. I could kill her and get away with it. You know what? I've never lost a court case yet. Dino ought to know. I ain't gonna start with her.
What is happening to you?
Huh? Oh, God. Hey, it's my warrior mode. It's got nothing to do with us. Come on. Give me a smile. It's okay. Come on. Yeah. So look, I need you to do me a favor.
Sure, what do you need?
I need you to testify that you had an affair with Dina. Oh.
I can't do that for you, Dick.
You know, it seems to me that you asked me for a favor once. What did I say? I'm not obsessed with this. I don't care what my crazy sister says.
Liz isn't crazy, Dick. She only suggested...
Giving him a continuance, huh? No way. We're ready. If they're not, screw them.
She's having surgery.
It's some crummy eye operation. Not even life-threatening. Hey, wait a minute.
When they give you this operation, do they cover your eyes?
They have to patch your eyes. Why?
Well, I was just thinking that you could put on your uniform, sneak into her room, inject her with insulin.
Are you out of your mind?
Hey, it's a joke. Come on, come on. Get in there.
I don't care if he is my brother. If you know what's good for you, you will not marry Dick.
I have to. Look, I can't start thinking like that now, Liz. Dick was there for me when I needed him. He changed my whole life. Now he needs me. This will all be over soon, and things will be back to normal. He's just under an immense amount of pressure.
It's his pressure. He made it. It's not yours.
I'm his only stability. Look, the trial is a week away, and it's not even like it's a private matter. I mean, every accusation she makes is all over town. Dina's trying to destroy his life. All he's doing is fighting to keep it.
Damn.
He is alleging you cheated on him. Are you sure there's nothing? I need the truth, Dina. I don't want to be crucified with it in court.
There's no one. There has never been anyone but Dick in my whole life.
You'd never betray me. I love you. You know you're the only one I can trust.
No, I'm not. You're a very loyal friend. I have something to tell you, and I hope you're going to be happy about it. I'm pregnant. We're going to have a baby. Are you happy about it?
Am I happy? Yes, I'm happy. That is wonderful. That is so great. That's terrific. Hey, as soon as I beat this damn divorce thing, you know what? We're gonna get married. We're gonna get married in Aspen on skis.
I'm not getting married on skis.
All right, wherever you want, we'll get married. But, you know, meanwhile, I think that
Maybe we shouldn't tell anybody. I mean, just for a while.
You're superstitious?
Yeah. Yeah, just a little.
Oh, she was with many different men. Doug Cantwell told me that he had sex on several occasions with Dina.
Objection.
He threatened me with everything. He was going to prove that I was a whore. He was going to sell everything out from under me.
Why do you suppose he wanted to do that, Dina?
That's Dick. You see, I want a divorce, and I want a settlement that's fair, and that's not what he wants. And when you do something that Dick doesn't want, you become the enemy, and he would do anything to hurt you.
No statements right now. We'll have something for you later. Come on,
we'll talk to you later. I haven't got anything to say right now.
Dick, how do you feel about the verdict?
You know what? I'll tell you the truth. I think we did real well in this matter.
He's crazy, Daddy. I mean, Dina got more than he did. I can't believe he lost. Look, I better go, okay? Bye.
No, it's not over. No, it is not. It's payback time. Everybody who took advantage of me during the divorce, they're gonna pay. You got that?
Dick, look, why don't you just let it go? I mean, who cares who won?
Look, don't tell me what to care about, all right? I don't lose. What is that, huh?
What?
What is this? Go put on something tighter.
I can't fit into anything tighter.
Oh, why is that?
You know why.
Yeah, the baby. You know, this baby. Timing is all wrong, okay? I don't feel ready.
Well, I mean, of course we're not ready, but we have 7 months to get prepared.
I don't want the baby. I just want things back the way they were.
Dick.
I want you to take care of it.
You know that I would never do that.
I told you to go change that dress.
What are you, Gracie? I mean, for God's sake, we are talking about a baby.
Would you sit down and let me move this to Gracie, okay? They gotta get this done. He could be back any minute.
I found you a month to month. He won't find you there.
Liz, thank you. I know what it means for you to be taking my side in all this, especially since Dick's your brother.
It's not about family. It's about what's right.
Look, it was just a bad argument, Daddy.
Yeah, well, honey, well, I don't like the way you sound. Look, your mother and I have been saving money to come see you. Why don't we just come see you right now?
No, I don't want you to come now. Look, Dad, I'm all right? Maybe in a few weeks, just promise me.
Well, what's the number there?
It's better if you don't have it. I'm afraid Dick will talk you into telling him where I am. I'll just call you later, okay?
Becca, your mom wants to talk to you.
No, Dad, I've got to go. Bye. I couldn't let them see my face.
Becca? Honey? I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. Becca? Yeah, this is Dick Strang. I've been robbed.
Listen, if you don't settle this with Strang, I'm going to file a complaint with the DA, and you're going to find yourself in jail.
This is nuts. The furniture was hers. Dick gave it to her. What are you guys doing?
Look, I'm under a lot of pressure here to file these charges. I think it'll all go away if she'll just settle it up with Dick.
Grand theft? Ugh, it's baloney. We're all Dick's buddies. How stupid does he think we are?
Why is he doing this to me? Hey, I'm pregnant with his baby.
Oh, my God. Now it makes sense. Rebecca, honey, he's afraid that you're going to go after him for paternity.
No, that's
Rebecca,
not it.
Rebecca, listen to me. He's just lost half of his assets to Dina. You're carrying his baby. That gives you power. You walked out on him. That gives you control. I told you Dick cannot stand to lose control to anybody or anything.
Yeah, but to me, I mean, I would never hurt Dick.
I know that. But Dick... Rebecca, I want you to be very careful. Remember what he tried to do to Dina? He hired private detectives. He had her followed. Tried to destroy her in any way that he could.
He didn't love Dina.
He did once.
Rebecca, I'm glad I caught you.
Lewis, is everything all right?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm fine, but it's Dick. I was just with him. He is devastated over this breakup.
He's devastated? Look, he's the one who...
He knows. He knows. He's fallen apart, Rebecca. He put himself under a lot of stress, and he just snapped. And you're the only one that can pull him together. Now, he wants one more chance to talk to you again, face to face.
Lewis.
Now, he'll understand if you don't ever want to see him again. He will abide by your decision. But please, just think about it. Oh, honey, he loves you so much. I have never seen him like this.
Becca, this is such a mess. What happened to us? Will you come in? Please? Your eyes. You look so sad. I never thought they'd look at me that way.
You made them sad.
I know I did.
I'm scared of you, Dick.
Please don't say that. I want you to feel safe with me like you always did. Who can take care of you better than I can? I love you so much, Rebecca.
What about the baby and the things you said to me?
I know. I know, Heidi. I was crazy after the divorce. I let the hostility take hold of me. We made that baby. Of course I want it. I want whatever is a part of us. This is Rebecca Dubrovich. She's the one that stole from me.
Why don't you just settle up with Strang?
Look, he can have the stupid furniture, all right? He gave it to me, but he can have it back.
He's willing to drop all the charges. He just wants to make sure that you're not gonna hurt him. That's all. That's all he wants. Right? Done. Why don't you just sign these papers and that'll take care of it.
Breach of promise? Paternity? So I'm supposed to say that Dick isn't the father of my baby and we had no relationship?
That's a lie. I'm not signing that.
Okay. We're going to move you into the general population. You know what women in jail are like, Rebecca?
Oh, after being around you and Dick, go ahead. I'm sure they'll look good to me.
Why didn't you tell us about the baby?
I was humiliated. He didn't want it, Mama.
Well, look what he's put you through. You should have just signed the papers and be rid of him.
I couldn't, Mom. I'd be signing away my child's father. I couldn't turn everything that made this baby into a lie.
Sweetheart, I want you out of here. I want you to come home with us to Los Angeles.
Dad, we've been through this before. I'm out on bail, and I can't leave Houston while the theft case is pending.
I don't like leaving you here. My little girl in a town run by these thugs.
I'm not a little girl. And if I was 2 weeks ago, I'm not anymore.
Police are dragging their heels on this one. I want you out there tracking her.
Done.
Can't do it.
Don't tell me that, because any DA can swear out a search warrant for her apartment.
Look, it's 5 o'clock on Friday. You're a private citizen. It's unusual for a private citizen to swear out a warrant.
I want it.
Papers here, ma'am. We'll get out of here, all right?
Brian, the cops are here with it. Come over here, please.
Be careful with that. Careful. Put it in there. Tie it down.
Doing.
Oh, yeah. Bring your camera.
You son of a bitch.
Hey, watch your mouth. I'll lock you up, too.
Brian, they're taking everything. Things that my parents gave me.
Come on up here, Dick.
We'll let him take it. This is the best thing that could have happened. Now we've got a case.
Wes, I'll give Rebecca $20,000 if you'll get her out of town. Anything could happen. Those two are so damned intense.
Rebecca, I'm so sorry about what happened. I have no idea what Dick's up to.
I do. All my tires were slashed. He's still pressing that lawsuit against me. All of our friends were afraid to cross him. Except for Brian and Liz, there's nobody left.
Well, whether you believe it or not, I'm here. If you ever want to talk, please just call.
Hello?
Hi there.
heard you ran 22 miles yesterday.
You still preparing for the Honolulu Marathon?
Come on, you don't think you can do anything in this town without me knowing, do you? I had you followed. All four of my tires were slashed, and there's a lawsuit against me, and all my friends are afraid of Dick.
You're out of your mind.
I know. And it's because of you. Because I love you so much. Come back to me. We'll start over. A clean slate.
No, just stay away from me. I want nothing to do with you. Look, it is one thing after another. He will not leave me alone. I have filed several complaints with you. I've written to the governor. Nobody will do anything.
Ms. Dobrovich, regardless of what you may suspect, there's nothing we can do unless he...
You know what? Fine. Why don't you just wait until there's another famous Texas murder?
Break. You need one. Come on.
So, you still training for that Honolulu Marathon? Yeah. Jogging is my new obsession.
Better than your old one.
I think he's gonna hurt me. Sometimes when I'm walking down the street, I imagine someone running me down.
Oh, Rebecca, he does.
Dick once said that he could get away with murder in Texas.
You are giving this man too much power. Just forget about him and move on.
Hello? Look, why don't you just leave me alone? You're not scaring me.
Hi, honey.
It's Dad. You okay?
Your mom doesn't know I'm calling.
I'm fine, Daddy.
Good.
Rebecca, you would tell me if there was anything seriously wrong, wouldn't you? Now, I've got a bad feeling about this. I got a call from somebody named Tom.
He offered me money to get you out of town. He, said anything could happen.
He's just one of Dick's friends. He's trying to scare me.
Well, let them scare you. Why don't you come home?
I'm not allowed to yet, but I will.
Okay, right after the trial.
Good. Honey, I just want to get you out of Houston. Look, your mom's coming. I gotta go. I love you, Becca.
I love you, too.
Wide shot wounds in the back. Yes.
Oh, God, it's Rebecca. Dr. Graham, Dr. Fisher, stats!
It's not a homicide. Girl's still alive.
Yeah, well, we were treating it as routine, but it might not be. Just got a call from an undercover cop. About a month ago, he got a tip that Briggs Gerard was offering $10,000 to kill the DeBradish girl.
A month ago?
Yeah.
Why didn't somebody follow it up?
Well, he says he filed a report. It got buried. Nobody saw it.
What a shame. You know, I loved her. And I could have kept her safe. She was so stubborn. She only has herself to blame. Sisters, they asked your class, who wants to be a priest and who wants to be a nun? And you raised your hand with the boys, and all those nuns, they were so mad. So they called me to the principal's office. They told me what happened, and I remember what I said, sweetheart. I said, yeah, Rebecca wants to be a priest, but what she really wants is to be a saint. Be a saint, you have to stay with us to do what needs to be done. Stay with us.
The man said the deal was 10,000.
What man? Was his name Alexander? The car you drove was registered to a Robert Alexander. Ever seen him before?
Yeah, that's the man. He hired us to kill the girl.
I feel just terrible about what happened to Rebecca. You know, if I knew where she was, I would send her flowers. You're welcome. So where is she?
Harrington Hospital.
I'll go find out if she's really paralyzed.
All right.
Well, we've got you pretty well wired up here, which is why you're having such difficulty breathing.
Bilateral hemopneumothorax. What about the spinal cord? Where was it severed? T4, right?
What does all that mean?
I have no feeling, no movement, no control of my body from the chest down.
Can you help her? Can you make her better?
Of course. Things can always improve, but realistically, she's never going to be able to walk again.
Oh, my God. Oh, Beck,
Rebecca, you come home with us and we'll take care of you. In your own room.
Becca. Rebecca. What we care about is that you are alive. I guess we should thank God for that.
Both of you just stop it. Listen to me, I will walk.
She's using the name Susan Jones, and she's paralyzed from the chest down.
Okay, fine.
Hi. How you doing?
Great.
Right. I know, it's tough being sick. Listen, you want me to wash your hair for you?
You're kidding. I would kill to have my hair washed. I feel so grubby being in bed all day.
This is Assistant District Attorney Frank Cameron. Don't waste our time. We already have a signed confession from the shooter implicating you as the man who hired him. So, give us something we want.
Did Briggs Gerard actually ask you to kill Rebecca Dobrovich?
I'm in Gerard's office when he gets a phone call. I assume from Dick Strang, because when he hangs up, he pulls out a file with Rebecca Dobrovich's name on it. Then he leans forward and says he wants her to disappear.
So what actually happened to you? I mean, your injury.
Spinal cord injury. It was severed.
Did you see who? I mean, how did it happen? Relax. Enjoy it.
We got Gerard, and he's our link to Strang.
Strang? No way, Kenny.
Oh, Frank, don't give me that crap. He set this thing up. You know it.
I don't know anything. I'm not dragging a man like Dick Strang into court without some hard evidence. I'd get my butt kicked. We can't go near Strang.
Your real name is Rebecca, isn't it? I mean, I read the papers. Aren't you the girl who went out with Dick Strang?
No. I think you've got the wrong person. Do you think you could call me a nurse?
The nurse is on break. But don't worry. I'm well qualified to administer medication.
No.
What's going on here?
There was this volunteer. She was washing my hair. She tried to give me medication.
What are you talking about? We don't have volunteers at this hour of the night, and they don't give medication.
Call the police now.
We're going to go out the back way. The ambulance is going to take you straight to rehab. I'll ride with you. You do need to change your name again, but I think you'll be safe there.
I won't be safe until Dick is behind bars.
Call me on the cell phone, okay? Oh, whoa, I got nothing to hide. Listen, I was shocked to find out about the shooting of Mr. Brogich.
Have the police questioned you?
No, absolutely not. You know what? My name has been unfairly exploited in this case by innuendo. I feel terrible about what happened to Rebecca, despite the fact we no longer see each other. If you'll excuse me, I gotta run.
Steph, what was that Polish name that you gave me when I was born?
Janneke.
Janneke. Janneke. Janny. My new name is Janny Smith.
You'll always be my Becca.
No, I won't, Daddy. That girl died with 4 shots to her back.
Briggs Gerard, we have a warrant for your arrest.
For what?
Solicitation to capital murder.
Nice work.
We don't want to overdo it.
Overdo it? Randy, give me a break. We worked for 30 minutes. I'm used to working out several hours a day.
Well, that was before your injury.
I know my body. I know what it can do.
Jenny, the key to your healing is your acceptance of your limitations.
You accept your limitations. Leave mine to me.
Can I get a statement, Dick?
Oh, I can't say anything right now. Talk to you afterwards, all right? How you guys doing today?
Are you in any way responsible?
What's going on? You look great in blue. Hey, the Rocket's gonna win tonight, so all I can say.
Today is the opening day of the sensational theft trial of Rebecca Dubrovich, the woman people called the Golden Girl. Dick Strang's former mistress entered the courtroom in her wheelchair, escorted by esteemed criminal lawyer Dick DeGaren. Her million-dollar legs hung limply, her toes pointed inward.
Speak later.
We're on the record in the matter of the People versus Rebecca Dubrovich.
Your Honor, we are here to urge you towards a speedy resolution to this matter. The defendant has been a victim of an assassination attempt.
Objection, Your Honor.
Just a moment.
Your Honor.
I said just a moment, Mr. Gould.
We believe the complainant in this case, Dick Strang, is the one who hired, through intermediaries, those assassins.
Your Honor!
Order! Order!
Rebecca and her lawyers are using the press to try and frame me. I mean, it's a sympathy ploy.
Just play a Little Red Riding Hood. And they got to have themselves a big bad wolf. That's you, sugar.
Absolutely. Look, Bella, I want you to quote me. I am not a defendant in this case, and I've been told I'm not even a suspect. You know, the only crime I ever committed? To fall in love with a beautiful girl from California.
And Lori Pell, Maine, is this year's marathon women's champion. The personal best time of 2 hours, 34 minutes, and 25 seconds.
Hey.
Hi. What's this about?
All charges in the theft case have been dismissed.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
I wish my news was as good. TA's not going to move on Strang. Not unless we have a concrete link.
Well, what about Brooke Sherrard?
He's not talking.
Why would he take the fall for Dick?
Money. He'll be out of the pen someday. And when he does, I imagine there'll be a nice fat bank account waiting for him.
So Dick Strang wins again?
No, not this time. We're going to file a personal injury suit against him. If we can't get him in criminal court, we are going to nail him in civil court. He will pay.
I don't want his money.
Come on, Jenny. You have medical bills you cannot pay. You're forced to live in a state facility while Dick Strang lives in luxury. No more. We're going after him.
What's all this?
I'm researching everything about my injury.
Look, kiddo. I just got the word. They're releasing you. Well, there's nothing more we can do for you here and without insurance.
I can't leave here. I'm not ready.
You'll never be ready until you do it. It's scary being on your own, but it's also great. It's the beginning of living again.
Yeah, if someone doesn't kill me first.
Dad made this ramp for you, so you can come and go as you want.
Your mom will stay home with you while I'm at work, and then I'll get home just as soon as I can.
You know, I don't want you guys rearranging your lives for me. It's been nothing's driven me home like an invalid child.
Honey.
No, listen, I love being home. It's my decision. No special treatment, okay?
Here. Kelly, this is...
Don't. I'm not your sister. You're not my brother. I don't want to have anything to do with you. You're dead, as far as I'm concerned.
My sister's nuts. I'm really worried about her.
Tonight's story is about the work of Dr. Gerald Petrovsky. Through the use of tiny computers, he has enabled certain paralyzed people to work out with weights to improve general health. and eventually even to walk.
In layman's terms, my computer sends electrical impulses to the muscles, forcing them to move. Leslie here is completely paralyzed from the chest down.
Dr. Petrovsky's makeshift computer is sending information into her leg muscles, bringing them back to life.
Oh my God, look at that.
Honey, I hate to see you get your hopes up. That doesn't mean this would work for you. I mean, you just don't know.
Yes, I do. That's the exact same injuries I have. Dr. Petrovsky.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Jenny Smith.
Nice to meet you.
I know that you're not taking on any more research subjects, and I'm already on the list, but...
I'm sorry, we have limited funding. Sorry.
I know, but if I don't get this out now, I may never get another chance to. I've been waiting here all day, and I'll wait for another 6 months if I have to. But I want to work for you. Look, I have experience as a trauma nurse, and I'm working towards my medical degree. I brought my CV. I've done extensive research in spinal cord injury since my accident, and I know that I can be invaluable to your work.
I just don't have it in my budget for more staff. I'm sorry.
So then don't pay me.
Look, if you're serious, I just don't know what I can do for you in return.
I'll find something. Look, I just want to be involved in what you're doing here.
Then why don't you come back tomorrow and take a look and see what's what?
Right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You got five more? Come on, give me a couple more. Yeah, that's it. Okay, one more. There you go.
You were a runner?
Yeah.
Me too. Should see my legs then.
Well, your legs look great.
Thanks. I've been working really hard. I've got 8 more minutes here. Then I'll show you the stationary bikes.
Okay.
Believe this crap. The saint I set up for a shooting. Hey, where were you? I don't know who the hell they think they're dealing with here. Suing me for her injuries. All I ever tried to do was help her.
They can go after all your assets.
They can't get anything from me, man. You know what? I'm basing everything in Europe now. All my business interests in Europe. I just want to see them try and get me into a Texas court.
All right, we're all set for the demonstration. I want you guys here at 8. Oh, and I'm going to need someone to run some tests tonight.
Let Jenny do it.
I need someone who knows the drill.
I do. I've been watching for weeks.
Carla.
I can't, Dr. P. I got a date.
Well, it looks like you're stuck with me.
So how do you stay in such good shape?
Well, actually...
I know. You're in there every night using the machines.
Dr. P, my dream is to walk the Honolulu Marathon. I was in training before the shooting, and I promised myself I'm gonna walk it. I mean it.
I know you do. And that's the problem. My computer is not a new pair of legs. And it wasn't designed for that kind of long-term stressful use.
Well, then we better improve it.
Okay, hotshot. What's on your mind?
I hope you won't get upset if I show you something that I've been working on, but you can replace those clunky boots with running shoes. And then instead of the metal, use this clear plastic that's flexible. I mean, it's more comfortable, it's lighter, and cosmetically, it looks so much better. You know, just because you're paralyzed doesn't mean you don't want to look good. It's not finished yet, but I'd love to test it out.
Set up a study. I'd like to see it.
So I want to complete the corporate transfer to London by tomorrow at 2 GMT. I don't have time for screw-ups. All right. And call Spence. Tell him I want to know what she's doing every minute.
So sorry. I thought this obsession was yours. I had no idea you were just defending yourself.
You know, I'm always defending myself against something. It's like this constant need to recover. And I would just like to live.
I know you, Janie. You'll get past this. And when you do, to be there.
Does this woman look disabled to you?
Your Honor, we have witnesses that will testify that Janie Smith's injuries are minor. We have a nurse that will say she has seen her walking on her own without any equipment. We have witnesses who will say that she is a tramp.
Your Honor, I am getting real tired of listening to him malign this woman. Now, Dick Strain could have stayed around to make his ridiculous and, I might add, actionable claims, but he did not. He snuck away like a thief in the middle of the night because he has no defense to this matter. Now, the only issue before this court is the nature and extent of my client's injuries and Dick Strang's responsibility for those injuries.
The court agrees, Mr. DeGaron. In light of Mr. Strang's repeated failure to appear before this court, I am entering a default judgment for Janie Smith in the amount of $28.6 million for past and future damages.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Think you'll ever see the money?
You know, it doesn't matter. I feel vindicated. Somebody in the system, a judge, said that Dick Strang injured me and that he has to pay. Kenny, you can let go now.
Can't. I'm not finished. I'll be in touch.
Good work. Congratulations, honey.
Thanks.
What is all this letting go? You, Ms. Obsessive?
I was, wasn't I? You know, I guess I still am about some things, like my work and my training.
Anything else?
What?
Last three times I've called you, the name Jerry has come up. Come on. I want the dirt.
Welcome to Brussels, Mr. O'Toole.
Thank you.
Well, Janie has something that she'd like to show you.
Really?
Board was down on Jerry. Why are you doing this? What about our funding? Why are you sticking your neck out for a marathon? And he said, because I want to make dreams come true. I couldn't believe it.
Sorry.
Now you need a phone, Jerry. There's one in the den.
Thanks. Sorry, occupational hazard. I'll be right back.
Isn't he great?
You tell us, Janneke.
He is. He's a good man. And he does such good work. He's gonna change the world.
I don't care so much about the world, only you.
Well, I don't know if he changed me, or I did, or just time, but I do feel that this is my second chance.
Then this is good, honey.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. You have been awfully quiet, Dad. What do you think?
I think you finally found your Albert Schweitzer.
I am really excited about this, Jenny. I mean, I think you're crazy trying to walk a marathon, but I get to go to Hawaii.
Yeah, well, don't pack your bikini. It's going to be all work.
It's 5 a.m. here in Hawaii, the start of one of the toughest of all international marathons.
Hello? Yeah, she's right here. Hold on.
Honey?
You.
Hello?
Congratulations.
Saw you on the news. Can you fly to Houston?
I've got a surprise for you.
Jenny, this is State Department Special Agent James Jones.
Hi.
This is Dr. Petrovsky.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
A warrant for Dick Strain's arrest.
Why? What happened?
Well, it seems that Mr. Strang has been involved in passport fraud. Maybe he's running a fraudulent international service.
So how are you guys going to serve him with the warrant if he's out of the country?
We've been tracking him. He flies out tomorrow under a false passport as a Richard O'Toole. He has to change planes in Dallas.
We got him.
Flight 822 to Newark is now boarding at 872.
Dick Strang?
Dick Strang, and arrest.
You did with it. That was you, sweetheart. I can let go now.